Kind regards to all of you, and welcome to the lesson on creating a macro. So creating macros is so beneficial if you want flexibility. It will also lead to better productivity. So it's all good. I'm going to show you two different ways to create a macro. The latter I prefer. I think it gives you even greater flexibility, and I think you'll agree with me after you see these two different ways. So let's start with the first way to create a macro. The way you go about it is to first hit the percent sign and type in macro. This is where you name your macro. I'm going to call it some stats. Let's make the procedure proc means, which will do some statistical analysis for us, some descriptive statistics for us, as part of our macro. And we're going to say that we want it done on the variables price and tax. You have to type in run, but you also need to close it with a percent M end, and then also put a semicolon. So let's go over this percent macro to start your macro. This is naming your macro. We are doing a proc means. We want some statistical analysis as part of our macro. On which variables do we want it on? We want it on price and tax variables. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a data step, and I'm gonna make a new data that's going to be called house price 2. I'm gonna tell SAS to read my original, because that's where the observations are. And let's do an if statement and say, if the type of home equals single, run. So we're telling it, if we only want to run it on the homes that are single types, so on these two, we don't want the duplex. The next step is something we call invoking our macro. The way you invoke it is the percent and the name of your variable. Of course, if you remember, the name of the macro is right here. So percent some stats to invoke it, semicolon, and we can run it. And you should get this. So you have the means procedure on, notice N2 for each variable, because we are running it only on the single homes and there's two of them. So very, very simple to do it this way. But this is how you set up your macro. You are setting up what you want within your macro, on what variables, and then where you can use an if statement or whatever else you want to code in, and then invoke it at any point. So it's just super, super cool and useful. Now think about how useful this is. I mean, once you've set up your macro, you can invoke it anywhere by just using the percent and the name of your macro. So absolutely anywhere. You can set up different macros, you can change your current one, and just invoke it anywhere, and you've got this flexibility of just making your coding so much easier. So it's really, really, really useful to have. All right, so let me now show you the other way with positional parameters. So we start the same way, percent macro, and we also add our name of our macro. I'll call it new stats. The difference comes here, and I will explain in a second what this is. Let me type it all out, and then I will go over it and explain it. I think it's easier like that, because we have many different components going on. So I think it's easier if I just do that. So let me just type this in. We end it with percent M end, and we're done. So it looks very similar, but of course a few differences. So let me go over it. So percent macro, we are starting our macro and we give it a name, and I've called it new stats. Now parentheses, of course, these are parentheses, And what you have inside is the actual parameters. So this is parameter one, this is parameter two, and you'll notice that they're separated by a comma. These names can absolutely be anything, but it makes sense to name them something close to what you will actually be performing. So for example, I named it Prague because this is supposed to represent the type of procedure that I'm going to use. This parameter is supposed to represent what type of procedure I am supposed to be doing. So when we go down here, notice that I've put proc, and then instead of putting proc means, what I've done is use the ampersand and called my parameter. And as a result of doing that, now I will have a choice of what procedure to actually use. So I don't have to use proc means. I can use univariate, for example. This, of course, remember, is where we, when we put var, it's a statement to declare what variables we want certain procedures to be done on. But again, I've just used the ampersand, called my parameter instead. And this also gives flexibility because now I can actually choose which variables I want to use. So now we're ready to invoke our macro, but one thing we forgot actually, semicolon goes here. And the way we do that is of course percent and then the name of our macro. The difference of course here is the positional parameters. So you're essentially copying this, but of course, you're putting the actual procedure because prog stands for the procedure type that you're going to use. So I can put means. And of course, a comma separates your first parameter from your second parameter, which of course represents the variables that you want to use. So I'll just put, I want to do it on price and tax. Then you can invoke your macro again and decide, you know what, I want to run a univariate on price. So look at the flexibility this gives you. You can run whatever procedure you want on whatever variables you want. And you can decide, oh, I just want to do it for one variable here, but I want to do it for two variables. Or I want to run this procedure on these variables, but a different one on these ones. So that's what I talk about when I talk about flexibility. And let's just run it. And there you are. So we've done the means procedure on price and tax, and we've done the univariate on our variable price. So there we go. So fantastic. Thanks very much, guys, for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.